Hello and welcome back to Switch and Lever. Man, it feels weird to say those words again. It's been a while since last, hasn't it? How are you? I'm still alive. I'm back, baby. I'm back, and today we're continuing our series of videos on 3D scanning. Previously, we have tried some different photogrammetry software and tested them against each other to crown a champion. Today, we're gonna take it up a notch and look at a dedicated 3D scanner, the just released Whale 3D scanner from 3DMakerPro, and compare it with one of the best photogrammetry solutions out there, reality capture. So, have a seat and follow along, because once again, welcome back to Switch and Lever. You know, this channel is long overdue for an overhaul, but now is not the time nor the place. Keep watching this space and we'll see what I'll do for the next video. Until then, let's get on with this show. Let's start with the boring stuff. Full disclosure, 3DMakerPro sent me this 3D scanner for review, but they have no control or input whatsoever on what I say, nor have they placed any sort of caveats on what I do with it or what I scan. To me, that speaks of a company who believes in their product. So we'll see if that belief holds up through the tests. The Whale 3D scanner comes in this pelican-like carry case, and inside we find a complimentary frisbee. Now, I assume that all of these grooves and lettering is unique and used in the scanning on some sort of turntable. Underneath, we find the actual scanner, which looks suspiciously, if I can get it out, suspiciously, much like some sort of ray gun. But the scanner, it has a really nice heft to it, and the fit and finish is actually spectacular. It's way beyond what I was expecting. This thing really breathes quality, which, of course, is promising for the next step. You guessed it, we're taking this thing for a spin, and we'll get back to the scanner and its specs in a little bit. In one corner we have Whale, and in the other we have photogrammetry. For a deeper look into photogrammetry, take a look at the previous two videos I made on the subject. Both are linked in the description. However, as a short primer, photogrammetry is the technology of taking a lot of photos from every possible angle of an object and having software figuring out the positions of the camera, and from there being able to understand the shape of the object. This is a strong scanning technology, but it does have its caveats, such as the need for a decent camera and having a lot of time to dedicate to both taking the photos and processing the results. As I can't compare the Whale 3D scanner against every photogrammetry program on the market, I picked one of the strongest contenders from the last video, and one I know that many both hobbyists and professionals used regularly, reality capture. So then, what do we scan? I will be scanning four items, varying in size, material, surface finish, and other geometric properties. These will range from reasonably easy to scan to rather difficult, and will compare the final results using either method. But then, what makes Whale so special? The Whale 3D scanner comes with a built-in near-infrared light, which makes it able to scan both in low ambient light as well as in strong lighting, which is something many other scanning methods struggle with. It has two modes, one to scan larger items and one to scan smaller items with tiny and fine detail. Finally, anyone who's ever used similar scanners are probably familiar with scanning markers, small, sticky, reflective dots which you put all over your objects to help the scanner pick up the shape of the object. I've even had them stuck all over my face when I got my face scanned some years ago. The Whale 3D scanner does not need nor use these markers, and will scan happily without them. Anyhow, on to the first object to scan. A shoe. A shoe? A shoe! This was chosen as it's a medium-sized object. The surfaces are very matte and easy to pick up, but it also has internal features as well as small loose detail in the laces. With Whale, all you need to do is to plug in the scanner and start up the software, and you'll get a camera feed, as well as a gauge which helps to guide you through the scanning. As long as you keep the gauge within the blue area, you know you're within good range from your object for scanning. To start your scan, all you need to do is to push the main button on the scanner, and the scan will start logging data. If the scene is too dark or too light, you can also change the light sensitivity by pushing the left or right buttons on the scanner. Whale will scan at 10 frames per second, so don't go whipping this thing around expecting it to pick up anything worthwhile. Move slow and methodically, and it will keep tracking your object and saving scan data as you move along. If it ever loses tracking, then slowly move back to where you were and it should automatically pick up tracking and continue the scan. It's really that easy, and it worked pretty easily straight out of the box once I got the knack of keeping it within the correct scanning distance. If I have one tiny criticism this early on, it's that the scanner does have a bit of weight to it, which makes arm fatigue play a role in how long you can perform one continuous scan before your arm starts shaking. However, you can also scan in increments and have the software align and stitch together those segments later, which also means that you don't have to rush as I am doing and try to get the entire object in one continuous scan. I am deliberately pushing the scanner as for what it can do, so if you spend more time and really get into it, it will undoubtedly produce better results. Once you've captured everything you want, then push the main button again and it will stop scanning, and then do an initial analysis of the data. This may take a minute or two depending on how long your scan was. After that, you can process it, which will turn the created point cloud into an actual 3D mesh. Hit process and wait for it to finish. In my experience, this was also a really quick process. The entire scan, from pushing the scan button to having a finished mesh output on my hard drive, was not more than a few minutes total. As we can see, Whale did not pick up every little detail of the laces, but it did a really good job overall and captured a lot of surface detail from the shoe. The inside of the shoe is a bit lacking, but that's due to me not pointing the scanner deep enough into the shoe cavity, rather than a downfall of the scanner itself. After all, you can't really capture what you don't point the scanner at. Moving on, let's try to capture the very same shoe using reality capture. For this, I used the same compact camera as in my previous photogrammetry video, and moved around the shoe trying to capture it from all angles. I ended up taking 95 photos and using those for the scan. Reality Capture had no problems whatsoever finding all the positions for the images and processed the mesh in about half an hour. The results with textures look spectacular, but the proof is really how it looks when we turn the textures off and look at the actual 3D mesh. Honestly, the results is still pretty good. Some distortions here and there, some unevenness in the surfaces, but it did actually capture laces decently good. Still, with both photographing, transferring, and processing the images into a 3D model, we're talking something around an hour spent of time. With more photos taken, that time of course increases exponentially. But let's move on, we have more models to check out. We also scanned a small plastic brain frog, which is challenging considering how reflective the plastic is, as well as how intricate the geometry is. To see how well either method works with flat planes without many features, I also scanned my old original Game Boy. And finally, we're scanning a really difficult object, a quite matte but also very featureless tiny hand. Basically, all of them were scanned in the same way, moving the scanner around slowly and scanning or photographing the object best I could using either Whale or my compact camera. If you're curious about the scanning background, it's a pattern of unique shapes, or fiducials, which gives the table the objects are laying on an easy surface to pick up for either scanner. This is not strictly necessary, but it does help scanning significantly, and it also somewhat evens the playing field between the two technologies, making this more about how well it actually captures the objects, as opposed to how well it picks up a flat table surface. If you want to use it yourself, a PDF is available in the description of this video. So, now, if we compare these results, what do we actually get? Is there truly a champion? Well, let's start out with the brain frog. Neither method truly impressed. Once again, reality capture looks good with textures, but once you turn them off, you can see how big of a mess the scan actually is. It couldn't really capture much, and what it did is really disappointing. Whale, on the other hand, is a bit like night and day. One side is featureless, and the other side, which has spent more time actually scanning, came out with far more definition. I suspect had I spent a fair bit more time scanning it all over, the results would have been more even as well. If the results for the shoe were reasonably even between the methods, I have to say that Whale takes the win on this. But only by a hair. The Game Boy unit is also really challenging. As anyone who has tried 3D scanning knows, reflective objects are a no-no, so I expect either method to struggle with the buttons and probably just leave a big gaping hole where the screen is. The result from Whale is beyond what I was expecting though. The surfaces are smooth, and while there are some distortions, they're mainly where the scanner simply couldn't reach to scan. Yes, the buttons are a bit wonky, and the screen is really nothing to cheer about, but that much was expected. Reflective objects are simply nigh impossible to get right. Reality capture, on the other hand, looks absolutely amazing. Until you turn the textures off. Again, the textures hides a lot of sins, but that won't help you if you want to 3D print your model, for instance. The whole Game Boy is distorted, and there is a lot of noise in the surface of the model. Where they have been reasonably the same so far, here is where Whale really shows its strengths and inches ahead with the finish line coming up. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, Whale also has a turntable which you can use to scan smaller objects. For this, there is also a special mode in the software with a guide taking you through the steps. As you can see, the small hand was scanned using this very turntable. This is pushing Whale both in terms of size, as we're approaching the smallest object it's specced to be able to scan, and it's also pushing reality capture, as this hand is very featureless, which makes picking up any sort of geometry insanely difficult. After turntable scanning, the hand sure does have some deformations, but I am very impressed with how well Whale managed to capture the hand overall. Reality capture, on the other hand, well, let's just say it didn't fare as well, and let's leave it at that. There is really no point in kicking someone who's down. So, in conclusion, Whale is definitely worth checking out if you want to do 3D scanning. There is nothing inherently wrong with photogrammetry, and I will continue to use both technologies in the future. But photogrammetry is much slower than a dedicated device with optimized technology to do actual 3D scanning. With a bit of time to get into everything that Whale can do, it is a very capable scanner. As usual, I will never tell anyone what to spend their hard-earned money on. That should always be a choice made by not just watching one random guy on YouTube. But Whale is definitely worth looking at further if you're interested in the field of 3D scanning. You can check it all out by following the links in the description. Thank you so much for watching this video. A lot has happened over the last almost year since I released my last video, but I really hope to be able to get back to making more videos in 2023, and hopefully then with a bit of a rehaul of the video style as well. But don't worry, you'll still recognize good old Switch and Lever. Until then, check out some previous videos, and I hope you all have a great holiday season. Until next time!